हेलो हेलो हाय हेलो हेलो एक्चुअली आई एम नॉट एबल टू हियर यू। हेलो हेलो हेलो
आई थिंक शी इज नॉट हियरिंग अस, सो आई विल आस्क हर टू रिजॉइन वंस अगेन। हेलो विद्या,
श्रवंती, आई कैन हियर यू नाउ। आई कैन हियर यू, बट आई एम नॉट एबल टू हियर द स्टूडेंट।
या दैट्स व्हाट आई विल आस्क हर टू रिजॉइन वंस अगेन।
ओके ओके श्योर। श्रवंती, कैन यू प्लीज चेक वेदर दे हैव अनम्यूटेड देयर माइक्रोफोन,
या
बिकॉज दे आर एबल टू हियर मी।
हेलो नित्या, या नित्या व्हाट हैपेंड,
या
यू आर अनेबल टू हियर अस।
हेलो श्रवंती, हेलो। हेलो हेलो नित्या, आई होप यू कैन हियर मी। सो माय नेम इज विद्या एंड आई एम गोइंग टू बी योर ट्रेनर फॉर दिस ट्रेनिंग क्लास। सो लेट मी जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूस अबाउट माय सेल्फ। My name is Vidya and I have been working in SAP ABAP for the past 8 plus years. I'm working in an MNC and I have been giving online trainings for the past 6 years. So basically bachelor's in computer science. So that's my basic academic qualification. So this is about me, and generally I would like I also would like to hear the students' introduction part, but unfortunately today we are not able to hear you. So can you just message me what is the objective of you going for this course? Different people enroll in this course for different reasons. Some of them are already working in SAP as functional consultants, and they want to gain some technical knowledge, so that is the reason they are going for this course. And some of them are working in other technologies like Java, C++, mainframes. So they want to move into SAP, so that is the reason they are going for this course. And others are they have just completed their MS, and since they are having good opportunities in SAP ABAP, they are enrolling for this course. So you can just message me briefly about yourself, what is the objective of you going for this course? Okay, you are with 7 plus mainframe experience, now planning to move to SAP. Okay. Okay, good. So many people have moved from different platforms. Like I have mentioned, C, C++, mainframes, .NET, right? So from all these, Oracle DBA. So many people have moved. So it's going to be basically it's going to be really really ABAP is really is going to be really really easy compared to COBOL. Right, since you are working in mainframes, you might be knowing COBOL. So ABAP is going to be really really easy and flexible compared to COBOL. So that's what my previous students told me who were already working in mainframes. So they say that ABAP is much more simple compared to COBOL. Right. So you are going to find it really easy then, since you are already into mainframes and you are having 7+ years of experience. It's going to be really, really easy for you. So let me go ahead and let me show you the course that we are going to cover in this training class. So let me open the syllabus. So roughly our course is going to take around 4 to 5 weeks, right? So when I say 4 to 5 weeks, like literally you don't have to think like only 4 weeks or 5 weeks, but depending upon the your understanding, how you were able to understand. So we may go a few days over also, right? So this is the course content we are going to cover in this training section. So the first part is going to be, and one more thing is, like, there is nothing theory part kind of thing. Everything is hands-on. So the training people are going to provide you the training server, and you have to practice, right? So whatever we discuss in the class, you just have to practice. So in above, there is nothing like a theory kind of thing where we just have to study and remember. No, it's not like that. Everything is hands-on. Whatever we discuss in the class, and I will also be giving you small assignments. So if you try to do those assignments, you will get a good hang of it, right? So the more, basically, the more you practice, the better you will be, the better comfortable you will become with ABAP, right? So try to, you should be able to spend at least 1 hour daily for the practice part, right? And I will also record the, I can also give you the recorded classes. So this is how I'm going to give you the record classes. Daily I will record the class, and then I will give you the classes like this for you. So all of these are the recorded classes, right? So I'll be sharing these. If you observe, there is some sequence number S1, S2, S3, S4, right? So they are in the sequence. So I will record the class, and I will give you these recording classes, and you can play these classes. You can rewind them, you can pause them, you can forward them. So you can play these classes as many times as you want. So it's going to be really, really make easy for you to practice while you are practicing, right? So this is the course content we are going to cover in this training section. So the first part is going to be introductory to ERP. What is ERP? What are the advantages of ERP? Right, and what is SAP? What are the different architecture in SAP? So the first two sections, basically, we are going to discuss it with the help of a PPT. And one more thing I'm going to do is, for each and every topic, I'm also going to discuss the important interview point of view questions, right? So that by the time we complete this course, you will also be ready to face the interviews, right? So you will have a fair idea, like, what are all the questions you can expect on each and every topic, and how you have to discuss them or answer them. So that way also, I'm going to prepare you in that way also. Because once you complete this training, probably you would be attending some interviews, right? So basically, you will be ready. By the time we complete this course, you will also be ready to face the interviews. So these two sections, the first two sections are going to be the introductory part, and we are going to discuss these with the help of a PPT. And interview point of view, you are not going to expect any, you will not be, we don't have to expect any interview point of view questions in this in this first two sections, because they are just the introductory part, and this would be just for your basic understanding, right? So from here, our actual so introduction to ABAP, for what is ABAP, right? How to log on to SAP. So we'll be discussing all these things in this section here. right? And the training people are they are going to provide you the server. So how to log on to the server. So we'll be discussing all those things in the third section. And from here, the actual ABAP starts from this topic, right? From here onwards, we are going to start our actual ABAP concepts. So here we are going to the first topic is the ABAP dictionary objects. So here we are going to discuss about tables, how data is stored in the tables, what are structures, right? And what are the different kinds of tables, what are search helps, lock objects. So we are going to discuss all these dictionary concepts in this section. Our next topic is going to be the ABAP programming basics. So here we are going to discuss, we'll start off writing with simple programs in ABAP, and we'll be discussing about the different data types, different operators, right? How to use different loops and conditional statements, and we will also discuss the string operations, internal table operations, and we'll also discuss the joins, how to use the joins, right? And modularization techniques. So all these topics we are going to discuss in this ABAP programming basics, and then we'll move on to our next section, that is the reports. So this is a really, really important topic, reports, because in each and every project you will be you'll end up doing so many, you'll end up developing so many reports. So this is a very, very important topic. So here we get to discuss what are the different types of report, classical report, interactive reports, how to use the control break statements, at first, at home. So we are going to discuss all these things here in this topic called the reports topic. And then we will move on to our next topic, that is the module pool programming. Here these are called as the dialog programs or module pool programs. So in this section we will see how to design the screen, how to create the executable program, and how to attach the program to the screen, and how to interact with the screen. So we'll be discussing all these things here in this sorry, excuse me. So we'll be discussing all these things in this section called the module pool programs or dialog programs. And then we'll move on to our next topic, that is BDC. So BDC is batch data communication. Whenever a particular client, whenever they are implementing SAP for the first time, the client will be having so much of legacy data. So all of that legacy data have to be moved into the SAP table. So here in this section, we will see how to upload the legacy data into the SAP system. And here there are different techniques to do that. So one technique is called the BDC technique, and the other technique is called the LSMW. So we'll be discussing all those techniques here. And this is also a really, really important topic, wherein especially in an implementation project, whenever they are implementing SAP for the first time, the client, they will be having so much of existing legacy data. So all of that legacy data have to be moved into SAP system. So we will use these techniques to upload the data into the SAP system. So this is a very important concept. And then we will move on to the scripts, SAP scripts. So this is also an important topic, SAP scripts. So whenever they actually these two things go together. So before we used to have like ECC 4.6 version, till ECC 4.6 version we only have SAP scripts. But later on they have come up, they have also come up with the concept called smart forms. So basically the advanced basically the advanced version of scripts is smart forms. So here we will see how to design the script, how to interact with the script, and how to create the smart form and how to interact with the smart form and how to link the program to the form. So we'll be discussing these two all these things here in this section, and this topic is also a very, very important topic, because in the projects we end up creating so many scripts and smart forms, right? So in each and every project we'll have so much of requirement for scripts and smart forms. And our next topic is going to be the SAP enhancements. So here we'll be discussing how to, like, most of the time the client will not be happy with the standard functionality that SAP is providing. So in that case we will have to do some customization. So so whenever we have to do some customizations, so we'll be using these techniques called user excerpts and customer excerpts. And so these two topics go together, user excerpts and baddies. Baddies is nothing but business add-ins. That means we are adding something to the business which was not there before. That means we are doing some customization. So this is also a really, really important topic, wherein the client most of the times they want to have their own customization. They want to add something custom relating to their business, right? So in that case we will be working with these enhancements and exits. So this is also a really, really important concept. And then we'll move on to IDOCS. So IDOCS is basically the communication between two different systems. And again, here if you observe, the IDOC and ALE, so these two things go together. So basically in these two things we'll be discussing how to establish a connection between two different remote systems. One is the source and the other one is the destination, and how to have the communication between these two systems, right? And so IDOCS and ALEs, so these are the two topics that goes together, and we'll be discussing all these communicating between two different remote systems in this section. And then we'll move on to our next topic, that is the BAPI. BAPI is nothing but business application programming interfaces. So here we get to see what are all the standard BAPIs that are available, and how to call a standard BAPI, and how to use the standard BAPI, and in case a standard BAPI is not available, then how to create a custom BAPI. So we'll be discussing all those things here in this section called the BAPI. So this would be our last topic. So we are going to cover all these topics, and for each and every area, for each and every topic, I'm going to give you the actual scenarios, like, because I have been working for the past 8.5 years. So I will be we'll be discussing the scenarios that I have encountered in my previous projects. So basically our session goes like, so this is the scenario, this is the requirement we have, and for this requirement this is how we are going to work, right? So this is how we are going to crack it. So this is how our session goes. And so this is about our syllabus. We have talked about the syllabus and duration. It will be 4 to 5 weeks, right? So it may go over also. It again all depends upon how the classes are progressing. So daily we will have 1 hour class, and then I will record the classes and I will share the recorded classes with you. And from your side you should be able to at least practice for 1 hour. Otherwise it's not going to be really, really much helpful, right? To be honest, because I have been giving trainings for the past 6 years, and I have seen so many given trainings to so many people, So, whoever practices well, it's going to, because when you are practicing, then only you will be coming up with so many doubts and concerns. So immediately, the very next day, if you clear them, it's going to be easy for you. So that is very, very important that you have to practice daily. Yeah. So yeah, any other concerns from your side, Nitya? Okay, so may I know where you are located? Like, what would be your convenient time to take the class? Okay, you are in Coimbatore. Okay, so what would be the convenient time for you to take the class? Same time. So 11 a.m. Is fine with me also, because I work in second shift. So basically, my work starts from 2 p.m. to 2 p.m. to 9 p.m. So I work in the second shift. So 11 a.m. Sounds fine for me also, right? So yeah, if you have any concerns, let me know. Otherwise, you can contact with the training people and you can talk to them. Regarding the other details or any other concerns you have. Okay, if you don't have any questions or concerns, then we'll wind up for today. You can talk to Shravanti, right? If you have any other. Okay, so I cannot say nice talking to you, because I didn't hear your voice. I am only seeing your chats, right? So okay, try to contact Shravanti and try to find out why you are not able to hear. Maybe I think because of the headset, right? So try to resolve that before you start the classes, right? Okay, Nitya. Nice chatting with you. Let me say chatting with you. Okay. Okay, then have a nice day. Bye bye.